Good morning.
Good morning and welcome to worship on this festival day. Today the pyramids are changed to white because we celebrate the festival of the Transfiguration of our Lord as we close out the Epiphany season and prepare to move into the season of Lent with our Ash Wednesday service this coming Wednesday night. Do we have any visitors who are with us this morning? Any visitors in this section? Or here? All we ask you to do is just raise your hand. Just want to acknowledge your presence, especially if you're a first-time visitor. Well, welcome to the members of American Lutheran Church. We have the privilege this morning of welcoming new members into the family of our congregation. It'll take place later in the service. We welcome those who are listening on the radio this morning. We're glad that you're able to be joining us in worship. And if there's anything we can do through American Lutheran Church to help you in any way, please contact the church office. Please note that the flowers on the altar this morning and our radio broadcast is sponsored in memory of Donella Gardner by June Ash, Van Ash, and we thank her for willing to share those with us this morning. We also want to remember in prayer this morning, Glenda Bond, who is hospitalized in Sioux Falls. She had knee replacement surgery. We were able to see her Friday night. She's recovering well, and there's a possibility that she could even be returning home today, and we pray for continued healing for her. We also saw Bishop Zelmer, who is recovering from knee surgery. He is doing well and should be able to resume his duties as bishop in the near future. But our hearts go out this morning with the family of Doug Gore. Death seems to be drawing near. We saw him last night. It's just a matter of time, but our hearts and prayers go out to his family as they wait in this vigil. We always acknowledge that we are a family of faith, and we always need to support each other in our journey together, and we invite you to stand and welcome each other. If you don't feel comfortable during this flu season of shaking hands, you can always do a fist bump or an elbow bunch or whatever you want to do, but welcome each other and greet each other. As we begin our worship service this morning, recognizing that we're moving into the Lenten season on this Transfiguration Sunday, we sing about the Transfiguration with the hymn, How Good Lord to Be Here.
Thank you.
The first reading is from 2 Kings chapter 2, verses 1 through 12. Now when the Lord was about to take Elijah up to heaven by a whirlwind, Elijah and Elisha were on their way from Gilgal. Elijah said to Elisha, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me as far as Bethel." But Elisha said, "As the Lord lives and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So they went down to Bethel. The company of prophets who were in Bethel came out to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that today the Lord will take your master away from you?" And he said, "Yes, I know. Keep silent." Elijah said to him, "Elisha, stay here, for the Lord has sent me to Jericho." But he said, "As the Lord lives and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So they came to Jericho. The company of prophets who were at Jericho drew near to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that today the Lord will take your master away from you?" And he answered, "Yes, I know. Be silent." Then Elijah said to him, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me to the Jordan." But he said, "As the Lord lives and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So the two of them went on. 50 men of the company of prophets also went and stood at some distance from them as they both were standing by the Jordan. Then Elijah took his mantle and rolled it up and struck the water. The water was parted to the one side and to the other until the two of them crossed on dry ground. When they had crossed, Elijah said to Elisha, "Tell me what I may do for you before I am taken from you." Elijah said, "Please let me inherit a double share of your spirit." He responded, "You have asked a hard thing. Yet if you see me as I am being taken from you, it will be granted you. If not, it will not." As they continued walking and talking, a chariot of fire and horses of fire separated the two of them, and Elijah ascended in a whirlwind into heaven. Elisha kept watching and crying out, "Father, Father, the chariots of Israel and its horsemen." But when he could no longer see him, he grasped his own clothes and tore them in two pieces. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
We'll read Psalm 50 responsively by full verse. The Mighty One, God the Lord, has spoken, calling the earth from the rising of the sun to its setting. Our God will come and will not keep silence, with a consuming flame before and round about a raging storm. Gather before me my loyal followers, those who have made a covenant with me and sealed it with sacrifice. The second reading is from 2 Corinthians, the fourth chapter. Even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. In their case, the God of this world has blinded the mind of the unbelievers to keep them from seeing the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God. For we do not proclaim ourselves, we proclaim Jesus Christ as Lord and ourselves as your slaves for Jesus' sake. For it is the God who said, "Let light shine out of darkness," who has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Six days later, Jesus took with him Peter and James and John and led them up a high mountain apart from themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no one on earth could bleach them. And there appeared to them Elijah and Moses, who were talking with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus, "Rabbi, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three dwellings, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He did not know what to say, for they were terrified. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and the cloud came from a voice, "This is my son, the beloved, listen to him." Suddenly, when they looked around, they saw no one with them anymore, but only Jesus. As they were coming down from the mountain, he ordered them to tell no one about what they had seen until the Son of Man had been risen from the dead. The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated, and we invite the children to come forward for a word with Suzanne.
Is it working? Oh, there it is. Okay. Well, I'll put the Smarties right here. Who wants to be the keeper? Oh, my goodness. Who hasn't done it before? You haven't done it? Okay, you can share. Okay. You notice Jesus doesn't have his outside coat on. Hold him up. He has just white. Just white on today. This is a special day. How are you? Huh? You okay? So, it's good to see everybody. Lots of you here today. So, it's Valentine's Day coming up, right? And you're going to have a party in Sunday school? Wow. I think I might have to come. How about that? Well, like I said, Jesus is all in white. So, did you hear what Pastor Bob read today? Jesus, they went up to a mountain. Some of the disciples and Jesus went up to the mountain. Have you ever been on the top of a mountain? Who's been on the top of a mountain?
Not me.
Not you. Okay. Well, that's okay. Someday you may be. So what do you see when you're on top of a mountain?
Trees.
Sometimes you can see way far away. Way far away. Like miles and miles and miles. Well, Jesus was up there with his disciples, and it got kind of dark and cloudy a little bit, like there wasn't any sun, and then all at once, a bright light shone, and Jesus looked like he was sparkling all over because he was in white. And so who do you think this bright light was? God, yes. And Jesus is God's son. Yes, right? That's what we learned, right? So Jesus, God is saying, this is my son. This is my son. And then, poof, disappeared. The light went and poof, disappeared. Well, then Jesus said, you know, we got to get down off this mountain because we have work to do. We have a lot of work to do. Work to do with people, because that is what Jesus is all about. Jesus is about working with all of you and all of everybody out there. So Wednesday is Ash Wednesday. What does that mean? Anybody know? What does it mean? What do you get on Ash Wednesday? You get that thing. Yep, that thing. That thing of ashes on your head in the shape of a cross, don't you? Uh-huh. And that is the beginning of Lent. Not lint, but Lent. Lent is when Jesus was on his way to the cross. So every Wednesday night, we will hear about Jesus going and making his way to the cross. But today is special because God said, this is my son. Listen to him. Listen to him. And you know what? Jesus talks to every one of us every day, whether we know it or not. He helps us to know right from wrong. Do you know right from wrong? Sometimes I do and sometimes I don't. Sometimes I do wrong things. Do you do wrong things? Do ya? No? Yeah? I think we all do it sometime. But this is what you need to always remember, guys. Always. That Jesus loves you very much. No matter what you've done, no matter what you haven't done. It doesn't matter to Jesus, because he'll love you no matter what. No matter what. Okay? You can remember that, can't you? Yes. So Jesus bless you all. Bless you all. So thank you for coming up. And of course, there are the Smarties that I spilled all over the floor last week. But they're in paper, so they're okay. So here are the Smarties. I'm going to put them down here. Oh, if you take more than one, then you pass it on, okay? Okay, you can take as many as you want, but you pass one on. Thank you for coming up. There are lots of children here today. So everybody is down in the Smarties, taking Smarties, Smarties, Smarties that they're going to pass out to everybody.
Suzanne.
Somebody left something up here. Hold it up. Who's missing it? There we go. Dear friends in Christ, grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. We gather today on the Festival of the Transfiguration, and as we listen to that story in Mark chapter 9, it needs to go back and just remember what was discussed by Mark in chapter 8. The 5,000 are fed. Jesus cures a blind man. Jesus goes with his disciples to Caesarea Philippi. Then Jesus asks this important question. Who do people say that I am? And you remember what they said? Some say you're Moses. Some say you're Elijah, come back from the dead. Because remember at the Passover, There was always that empty plate and the empty cup set at the family table, and that was the cup of Elijah, because they believed that Elijah would come back from the dead and usher in the Messianic kingdom. So some say you're Moses, some say you're Elijah. You're the one that's going to come and announce the kingdom of God. And then he looks at Peter, but who do you say that I am? And that's the question we all have to ask of ourselves. Who is Jesus for you? And what did Peter say? You are the Christ of God. And in our heritage, that's the most important statement. And we sing hymns like, the church's one foundation is Jesus Christ, her Lord. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. So when Peter said in Mark chapter 8, you are the Christ of God, that's a key statement for us in our own faith journey. And then Jesus said, that's well and good, but just know this. Three times he tells them, I'm going to go up to Jerusalem, I'm going to be handed over to the authorities, I have to suffer, and I will be put to death. And then he says, take up your cross and follow me, and you will save your life by losing it. So then we come to our reading for today, and it's 6 days later. 6 days later, we find Jesus on the mountain, the Festival of Transfiguration. Suzanne and I have been on a couple of study trips to Germany and spent some time in Wittenberg. And if you go to the first Lutheran church, St. Mary's in Wittenberg, and behind the altar there's a painting of Bethlehem. And the hills of Bethlehem are covered with pine trees. Now, I've never been to Israel, but there aren't any pine trees in Israel. So why? Well, nobody else had been there, but when they painted the painting, they just pictured it like Germany, so if there's hills, they have to be covered with pine trees. Well, I don't know what happened here. Okay, that's Mount Tabor. That's where we believe that the Festival of Transfiguration took place. It looks more like a big hill. It's almost like a Bear Butte out by Sturgis. It's tall. It's not as tall as some of the Black Hills, but this is the mount. Sometimes when we picture the Mount of Transfiguration, we think of this really high, tall place. Well, it is relatively tall, but it's not what we would consider a mountain in this country. And this is the view of the Sea of Galilee from Mount Tabor. So what happened? This cloud overshadows them, and there they see Moses, the giant of the Old Testament, the one that God called and said, you will lead my people out of slavery. They had been slaves for 400 years, and now he led them out of Egypt to the Promised Land. They also saw Elijah. Again, we said Elijah is the first and foremost of the prophets. We read about that today. Remember when Elisha, it was his turn then to take over after Elijah? Elijah's telling him, you realize, you know, I'm going to be leaving. And what does Elisha say? I know that. Let's not talk about it. Oftentimes, when there are difficult things before us, we don't want to talk about it. But just as Elisha kept pressing on Elisha, we do need to face it, and we do need to talk about it. And so that's why on this Transfiguration Sunday, we look forward past the 40 days of Lent to the glory that we will celebrate on Easter Sunday. And before we begin that journey, we need to see this glimpse of glory. And so during the season of Lent, we need to talk about what it means to be a faithful follower of Jesus through the highs and the lows of our life together. And I think what is really significant about the Transfiguration story, All this appears. And what does Peter say? We sung about it. It's good to be here. This is fantastic. Why don't we set up some booths? They figure that this took place during the time of the festival of booths. Let's make three tents. It doesn't get any better than this. Let's just stay right here. And then that cloud overshadows them, and they hear the voice, "This is my son, the beloved. Listen to him." And then what happened? Things just kind of spread apart, and all they saw was Jesus. That's a key lesson for each one of us. Last night, as I stood in the room of Doug Dorr, the family knows, and I knew, that death is drawing near. We don't know what time. It could be hours, it could be days. It may have already taken place, I don't know. We'll be going there after the service this morning. But what I encouraged them, as we went to the forehead of Doug and just made the sign of the cross, remember what that says? When we were baptized and united with Jesus in his death. And we'll hear that Wednesday night as ashes are put on our foreheads. Remember that you are dust, for the wages of sin is death. But that's not the end of the sentence. The promise is, if we are united with Jesus in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. And that gives us a confident faith that we can live our lives with this sure and certain promise that nothing, absolutely nothing, can ever separate us from the love that God has given to us in Jesus Christ. And even when we face the hour of our death, we push everything aside. Just what took place on the mount, and all we see is Jesus. So today we have that glimpse of glory. Have you experienced the presence of Jesus in your life? Have you been able to push everything aside so that you see clearly God speaking to you in Jesus? Do you listen to Jesus? That's the question we ask of ourselves today. I don't know if you're familiar with the book Nearing Home. It's Billy Graham talking about his advancing age and approaching death. And as he writes in his book, we focus on the gift of God's Word, the gift of the Holy Spirit, the gift of prayer, the gift of fellowship, and the gift of service. Living our life in the arena of God's grace given to us in Jesus Christ. And I love the words of the hymn, "Because He Lives." Because Jesus lives, I can face the future. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know who holds the future, and I can live just because he lives. So on this Transfiguration Sunday, you may not know individually what the future holds for you, but I hope you know who holds the future. And life is worth the living because Jesus lives. Amen. And now may the peace of God, which passes all our own human understanding, keep your hearts and your minds firmly rooted in Jesus Christ. Amen. Now we join together in singing, "What a joy it is to live in the fellowship of a congregation in the midst of the family of God. What a fellowship, what a joy divine."
Thank you. living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
You may be seated. We continue our worship with the gifts of our tithes and our offerings. Merciful God, receive the gifts we bring, ourselves, our time, and our possessions. Through this meal, unite us as your body, shining with the light of your justice and mercy, for the sake of him who gave himself for us, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. You may be seated. And will the persons who now desire to become members of the family of American Lutheran Church please come forward? Just have you come forward and stand right down here. Anytime you set a date for new members, I know we have some that are working, some that are out of town, but we're grateful that all of you are here and present with us today. And the order for welcoming new members is found on an insert in your bulletins this morning. We rejoice that God is at work leading new families into his family of faith. Let's welcome these new members now by reaffirming some affirmations about our faith, our church, and our mission. The church is a family of people caring for one another, forgiving each other. It is a family that weeps and rejoices together. The church is a family of a people with varieties of gifts, united by the presence of Jesus Christ. Do you want to share in that family? If so, please answer, we do. The church lives in the Spirit of God, gaining its power and life from the daily gift of the Holy Spirit. It is the life of the Spirit, a life of openness to the world and to all people, a life of continual searching and learning, a life of faith and doubt, a life of love. Do you want to share in that Spirit? If so, please answer, we do. The church is a mission, people who have a task of bringing the good news of God's forgiving, renewing love to all people. It is a people with a mission of justice, peace, healing, and love to share. Do you want to share in that mission? If so, please answer, we do. I ask you now, the family of American Lutheran Church, will you offer yourselves and your love to these new members? And will you ask them to join us in our life of service together? If so, please answer, we will with the help of God. Now, as a way of sealing our relationship with you, let us offer a prayer of thanks to God for you. We give thanks, Almighty God, that you have called us together into the fellowship of Christ, that you bind us in love of brotherhood and service in your church, and we humbly ask that we will be one in you. Grant that we may grow together in grace, be fruitful in every good work, and endeavor to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So I just ask that you turn around. We do have a gift for you that they will be bringing over to pass out. I also want to remind all of you, I'm just in my sixth week here, and when the first week I was here, I was asked to, we needed to set a date for receiving new members, and we did, but it's grown over the weeks, and we certainly want to welcome them. But the key is, for your responsibilities of members of American Lutheran, along with these new members, to engage them in the life of this community. And so we encourage you to do that. Some are coming from other faiths. Next Sunday, and this is for all of you, in the fellowship hall, we're going to have a session that will talk about what it means to be a member of a Lutheran congregation and the basics of our Lutheran faith. And we want to share that with our new members, but we also want to share it with all of you. So please, we invite you to all come back next Sunday, stay for fellowship time and this discussion about what it means to be Lutheran. So as they're passing out these gifts, let's welcome these new members with a round of applause. And for the new members, after the service, you please come back up. Suzanne is going to be taking a picture so that we can better introduce you to the whole family of American Lutheran Church. So when you receive your gift, you may go back and be seated. And again, we welcome you and thank you for being a part of the fellowship of this congregation. And we join together in prayers. Just go right over to the table. There you go. Gracious Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for the privilege of being your church. And we ask for your continued blessing upon these new members, and together as a fellowship of this congregation, may we reach out with your gracious love. We also remember today Glenda Bone, and we give thanks for the successful surgery. and pray for full and complete recovery for her. We also remember Bishop Zelmer as he continues his recovery, and we pray that he can return back to his office in the near future. But our hearts, especially on this day, go out to Doug Dorr and his family as they wait because death is drawing near. Be with them, comfort them with the sure and certain hope that nothing can ever separate us from your love. Lord, in your mercy. We also remember today others who are dealing with difficult issues. We remember Cheryl and Wade and Shirley, Ron, Ken, Dell, Ben, Caitlin, James. Keep them all in your grace. Lord, in your mercy. And we pray, Heavenly Father, as we come together on this Transfiguration Sunday and prepare for Ash Wednesday and the journey of Lent, help us to set a time to spend extra time in Bible reading and in prayer. As we come together on Wednesday nights for worship, help us use this season of Lent to deepen our faith relationship with you so that we can come on Easter Sunday and celebrate the glory of your resurrection. Lord, in your mercy, into your hands, gracious Father, we commend those for whom we pray, trusting in the name of Jesus, in whose name we pray. Amen. And it was our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night in which he was betrayed, that he took bread. And when he had broken and given thanks, he gave it to his disciples and he said, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup, and when he had supped and given thanks, he gave it to his disciples. He said, "Drink ye all of it. This cup is the new covenant in my blood, given and shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink of it in remembrance of me." And so when we eat of this bread and we drink of this cup, we proclaim our Lord's death until he comes. And we pray, "Amen, come, Lord Jesus." And we pray together as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. All is prepared. Please come forward at the direction of the ushers. The first table to be communed will be the service. Thank you. O morning star, fair and bright, you have refreshed us again with heavenly food. You are our dearest treasure. Go with us now, today, tomorrow, every day, that we may tell the story of your never-ending love and sing with your praise both now and forever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Go in peace, be the light of Christ. And on this Transfiguration Sunday, let's stand and sing together, Shine, Jesus, Shine. New members, if you'd please just go forward and let Suzanne take your picture. Go in peace, serve the Lord.